Tuberculosis and pregnancy. We know much about tuberculosis. Today we are going to discuss about the tuberculosis in pregnancy. If there is any difference between the course prognosis and management of tuberculosis in pregnant women and non-pregnant women. So what is tuberculosis? It is a common infectious disease caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It generally affects the lungs, but it can also affect other parts of the body. Then pulmonary tuberculosis is called when it affects the lung, and extrapulmonary tuberculosis is called when it affects other parts of the body. The common presentation is pulmonary tuberculosis. All of us know the signs and symptoms of pulmonary tuberculosis. What are the signs and symptoms of pulmonary tuberculosis? Prolonged cough with blood-stained sputum, hemoptysis, then evening rise of temperature, night sweat, weight loss, weakness and fatigue, decreased appetite, chest pain. Sometimes it is associated with chest pain. These are the common signs and symptoms of pulmonary tuberculosis. All of us know the common signs and symptoms of pulmonary tuberculosis. So a patient with prolonged cough, evening rise of temperature, weight loss, we have to rule out pulmonary tuberculosis. Then weight loss is so common in pulmonary tuberculosis, that is why it is historically called consumption. In our material medica we can see this word consumption. It was an old terminology. It indicates the weight loss due to tuberculosis. Sometimes consumption is also used for any type of weight loss. Infection of other organs can cause a wide range of symptoms. And what are the types of extrapulmonary tuberculosis? Tuberculosis also affects a central nervous system, or it causes meningitis, tuberculous meningitis. It is a very fatal condition. It may affect the lymphatic system. Then it is called scrofula. Usually it affects the lymphatic system of neck or cervical lymph nodes. It affects pleura. Another presentation of tuberculosis is the miliary tuberculosis. Tuberculosis sometimes affects bones and joints, that is called Pott's disease. Then another condition is genitourinary tuberculosis. All these are the different types of extrapulmonary tuberculosis. So today we are going to discuss about what is the effect of pregnancy on tuberculosis, what is the course of tuberculosis in pregnancy, if there is any difference between course of tuberculosis in pregnant woman and non-pregnant woman, what is the effect of tuberculosis on pregnancy, then effect of tuberculosis on fetus and newborn, then effect of medication. So this is this infection needs a prolonged treatment. If there is any contraindication in case of medication in pregnancy, then what are the different modes of transmission if it is transmitted to fetus, and what care should be taken regarding the breastfeeding of a tubercular mother. The first one is the effect of pregnancy on tuberculosis. The studies shows that there is no effect of pregnancy on tuberculosis. That means the course of tuberculosis in non-pregnant woman and pregnant woman are same. Pregnancy itself does not modify the course of tuberculosis. The lesions remaining the same. But consecutive pregnancy may, however, have a negative effect. Frequent consecutive pregnancy may have a negative effect. And again, the diagnosis of tuberculosis in pregnancy may be more challenging because the weight loss associated with the disease may also be temporarily masked by the normal weight gain in pregnancy. So we have seen that one of the main symptoms of tuberculosis is weight loss. But in pregnancy, we can see normal weight gain. So the symptom is masked in pregnancy. That is a challenging thing. Then what is the effect of tuberculosis on pregnancy? Pulmonary tuberculosis as such does not affect fertility. It does not affect fertility, but genital tuberculosis cause fertility. So we have to rule out genital tuberculosis in case of infertility. Chance of abortion, premature labor, IUGR, all are the side effects of pulmonary tuberculosis on pregnancy. Then transplacental transmission is very low. That is the transmission from mother to fetus, that is very low. So congenital tuberculosis is very rare. And if it occurs, the signs and symptoms are different from those of the pulmonary tuberculosis and extrapulmonary tuberculosis. The signs and symptoms of congenital tuberculosis include hepatosplenomegaly, respiratory distress, and lymphadenopathy. So a newborn of a tubercular mother have hepatomegaly or respiratory distress or lymphadenopathy, we have to rule out congenital tuberculosis. It is a very rare condition. Then the postnatal transmission to newborn from mother is high because of the close contact with the infected mother and the child. So care should be taken to prevent the postnatal transmission during the breastfeeding time of newborn. So we have to avoid the close contact of an infected mother with the child. It may cause transmission. Then the diagnosis. How can we diagnose pulmonary tuberculosis in pregnancy? It is the same. The method is same as in non-pregnant women also. So clinical features of evening rise of temperature, prolonged cough with blood-stained sputum, weight loss, chest pain, etc. We have to suspect a case of pulmonary tuberculosis. Then a confirmation test or a lab test includes Montax test or tuberculin test. It is 0.5 ml of purified protein derivative, PPD, is injected intradermally on left forearm, and the site is observed after 48 hours. If a lesion is present after 48 hours, test is positive. That is called a tuberculin test or a Montax test. It is a commonly used test to diagnose tuberculosis. Next important clinic laboratory examination is the sputum examination for acid fast bacilli, AFB. For this test, sputum examination for AFB, it needs 3 days morning sample of sputum. There are two types of AFB test, AFB smear and AFB culture. Acid fast bacilli smear and acid fast bacilli culture. But the culture takes 6 to 8 weeks to grow enough bacteria to detect an infection. Although it is a confirmatory test, but it is more time consuming, AFB culture. So what we are usually doing is the AFB smear test. Chest X-ray, one of the most important diagnostic method is the chest X-ray, gastric washings, diagnostic bronchoscopy, back tech test. It is a new diagnostic test to diagnose pulmonary tuberculosis. It is a modified cultural media. It takes less time as compared to other cultural tests. These are the diagnostic methods to diagnose a tuberculosis. It is same in non-pregnant women also, there is no difference. Then management of tuberculosis in pregnant women is very important, because here the problem arising because of the possible side effect of certain drugs used to manage tuberculosis. Some antibiotics usually prescribed for tuberculosis is streptomycin. It is highly teratogenic. That means it adversely affect the growing fetus. So streptomycin is contraindicated in pregnancy, tuberculosis during pregnancy. There are other antibiotics are available, safe antibiotics are available nowadays. So we are usually special type of antibiotics are given in tuberculosis of pregnancy. And the treatment course is 9 months. It is equal to the treatment course of non-pregnant woman. Obstetric management is same. There is no difference between obstetric management of a tuberculous patient and a non-tuberculous patient. We have already discussed that care should be taken to prevent the postnatal spread to newborn by close contact. So there is a chance of transmission from mother to newborn due to close contact. So we have to take the necessary steps to prevent the transmission from mother to newborn. Immediate next pregnancy should be avoided. Barrier contraceptive methods are best option for this type of patients. Test for HIV should be done in all cases of tuberculosis, because HIV and tuberculosis, it is a deadly duo and prognosis is bad in such cases. So HIV test should be carried out in all cases of tuberculosis. Then regarding breastfeeding, there is no contraindication for breastfeeding of tuberculous patient. So breastfeeding can be continued if mother is not having active tuberculosis. If mother is having active tuberculosis, there is a chance of spread from mother to child due to close contact. If there is no active tuberculosis, breastfeeding can be continued. Again, breastfeeding is not contraindicated when the woman is taking anti-tuberculous drugs. Anti-tuberculous drugs is also not a contraindication for breastfeeding. But breastfeeding is avoided if the infant is also taking the drugs. If the infant is also suffering from tuberculosis, we have to give medicine, anti-tuberculous medicine to infant also. In such cases, it is better to avoid the breastfeeding in order to avoid excess drug level. In case mother is having active tuberculosis, infant should be isolated from the mother. Then one of the most important preventive measure is the BCG. BCG should be given to newborn as early as possible. Thank you.